You, right there, are you looking to increase your hockey IQ, start making better decisions on the ice, and taking your game to the next level? Then look no further than the Hockey IQ game that you are about to play. The rules are very simple, and I'm gonna keep it simple. I'm gonna roll through five different clips, but before there's a play that happens that I want you to make a decision on, I'm gonna pause it. I'm gonna count to five. In that 5 seconds, you have to make a decision, and you have to stick to it. Then I'll roll the clip, talk about what happened, what could have done better, what went correct, what play was made, and then you decide if you made the right play or not, okay? Every time you make the right play, you get a point. Every time you miss it, you just don't get the point. It's best out of five. So at the end of the video, you should have a score, best out of five. I want you to take that score, put it in the comments below. Talk about the ones you got right. Talk about the ones you got wrong. Over time, consistently doing things like this are gonna help you make better decisions on the ice. So enough chatter. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. But let's go develop that hockey IQ. Clip number one. All right, hockey family, clip number one coming up. Now, again, the rules are very simple. I'm gonna play the video to a spot where the player has to make a decision. Now, all of these end up in a goal by Connor Bedard, but sometimes the decision has to be made by a different player on his team or by somebody on the other team making their wrong decision, which ends up leading to a goal. So I'm kind of setting the stage for the five clips that we're going to get. Now, after we review the play, I'll let you know if you said this, if you said that, you give yourself 1 point. If you didn't say that, you get 0 for that point, and that's okay because it's the process and the consistency that we're truly looking for here. So I'm gonna play this clip here and we're gonna be watching this player right here. I'm gonna pause it. I'm gonna count to five. You gotta make a decision. Then I'm gonna play it through to the end of the goal. Then we're gonna talk about the clip a little bit. Right here. Five, I'm gonna play it. Hopefully you made your decision, saying it out loud. Ends up being a turnover. Bedard gets back to the net. All right, let's run it back here. So, you need to start looking at these things early. You should be scanning. This player does a good job of scanning a little bit, but if you notice, he just looks left. So right here, he's just looking to the left side of the ice. And he sees he's got a little bit of support here. But what he doesn't see, because he doesn't look to his right or shoulder check all the way around to his right, is this player in the back. This is huge because all these other players, even the guys that are changing, are heading to the weak side of the ice. So when he gets to this part, what should his play be here? If he goes to the strong side, like he does, and wraps around, it ends up being a turnover. So the correct play here should have either been to try and hit the brakes and come back up the wall, or a hard reverse to that player we saw in the clip right before this, or in the frame right before this. So if you said reverse in any way, meaning coming back to the same side of the ice that he's on, you give yourself 1 point. If you didn't and you said, hey, wheel and hit this guy or wheel and hit that guy, then you don't get a point for this round, which is okay. Again, it's the learning that we're after here. But again, this clip right here shows all those players going to the strong side of the ice. Simple reverse there is gonna alleviate pressure and not bring everything to this side of the ice. Bedard does a great job making that pass. After he makes that pass, does he stand around and watch it? No, gets right to the net. Bada bing, bada boom. It's in the back of the net. All right, on to clip two. Hey,
before we go any further, did you know that Project Hockey has an app? And inside that app, every single day, there are Hockey IQ clips for you to learn from, for you just to simply press play and learn the game at a high level. There's drills to go along with that. There's strength sessions, mobility sessions, mindset sessions, shooting sessions, all those things inside the Project Hockey app. And on top of that, did you know that we have weekly Zoom sessions for you to jump on a live call with our coaches to develop that hockey IQ, to run through clips like you're about to see, to take your game to the next level, to start making better decisions on the ice. We do it every single day inside the Project Hockey app. So join us, there's a 14-day free trial. Love to have you part of our family. All right, now let's go do the work.
All right, here we go, clip number two. Now this is the decision made by the man himself, Connor Bedard, number 98. Again, I'm going to roll it. And then as soon as I hit pause, I'm going to count to five. And you got to make some type of decision. And then once that 5 seconds is up, I'm going to roll the clip through the goal. Then I'm going to run it back. And we're going to talk about the decision and see if you got a point or not. So here we go. Comes up the ice. Enters the blue line. Decide. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hopefully you've said something by now. Ting. All right, let's run it back. First of all, we have good speed through the neutral zone. And as we enter the zone, we notice a couple things. One, he's got support on his left side, right? Now, he could kick it that way. But because of this gap that these defenders have left, he knows that now he has space to get to at least where they're at. So he knows they're going to keep backing up a little bit. So worst case, his shot is going to come from this area. And if you have a shot like Connor Bedard, a shot from this area is key, is clutch, right? So you're going to take that every single time. He enters the zone here. So that's why instead of kicking it out, he drives, keeps driving and gets a shot because of this gap. So if you said in any way, driving towards the net for a shot, we don't want to kick it out because we have too much space here. We got to take advantage of this space. So if you said, get to the net, get a shot, or drive wide, try to beat these guys wide this way, get a shot, those will all get you a point. Yes, it's probably okay if you kicked it out, hit the wide guy, give yourself a point for that. But the main thing I want to see here is that we are driving because these D are backed up. Let me roll it forward a little bit. And he's taking this shot now at the tops of the circles where you're going to take that every single time, especially in overtime when these guys are backed up and you're just looking to get pucks on net right now. So again, if you said rush it because of that gap. So we got to start looking at these things, the different nuances, right? Where's the gap on the defenseman? Where's my guy going to be kicked out? Because if he passes it to this guy on the side here, right? If he throws it out this way, now this defender can go, these guys can gap up, and there's just nothing there. Okay? All right, on to clip number three. All right, here we go. Clip number three. Again, I'm going to roll this thing. As soon as I hit pause, I'm going to count to five with my hand. Maybe say it out loud. As soon as I get to zero, you had to make a decision out loud, and then you got to be honest and stick with that decision. If it's the wrong one, that's all right. Totally all right. It's a part of the process, right? It's how we get better every single day. All right. For this clip, though, we're actually going to be watching this guy right here. Okay, we're not going to be watching Bedzie. Sooner he will end up scoring the goal, but we're going to be watching this guy right here. So let's roll the footage. Go. 3, 2, 1. Time. Make your decision. Another big goal there. All right, let's roll it back. Nice little pressure down the wall. Kind of a whiff by that defender for the Jets on the wall. Blackhawks player pushes it through. Gets the puck in a prime opportunity to make a play. Now, couple option he has here. I would say if you said shoot the puck, I would say that's wrong, right? Because he's just at a bad angle. He's way outside the dots. And at this level, and at the most levels of the people that are here watching this, shooting a puck outside of this dot line, so outside here, these goalies are going to make that saves 99 times out of 100. So we got to find a different play to make. If you said, obviously, the nice little quick dish here to Bedard, because he's got tons of space, give yourself a point. If you said pass it across to this guy for a shot, there is definitely a lane there. Now, because, and this is kind of that next level, because this defender has their toes pointed this way, you want to pass this puck to 98, Connor Bedard, because he's going to have that much more space, right? Good players create space for themselves. Great players create space for others. So we really want to make sure that we're noticing these things. If you notice that these skates are like this, and you said, hey, skates are facing that way, I'm going to pass them Dart because it's going to give them more space, and this guy's more concerned about this guy, that's going to create more space. Give yourself a point. Now, if you still said try to thread this needle, I'm okay with that. Give yourself a point, but the play definitely goes to here. Now, let's finish this playoff. Pass gets made. Bedard gets a quick one-time shot. Watch what he does after he shoots. He goes to the net. Hopefully you said it. He goes to the net. Boom, he goes to that net. Ends up getting his own rebound. Takes a hit to make a play. All right? Okay, on to the next clip. Okay, here we go. Clip number 4. Again, keep track of your points. Write it down. If you're at 1, 2, 3, or 0 right now, it doesn't matter. We're just looking to get better. We're developing our hockey IQ by making decisions quicker, quicker, quicker. All right, for this one, we are going to be watching the man, Claude Giroux. He's going to come through the neutral zone and get into the Blackhawks defensive zone. Then he's got a decision to make. As soon as I hit pause, you need to make that decision within 5 seconds. And then I'm going to roll the play all the way through the goal. Spoiler alert, Bedard ends up getting it. And then I'm going to pause it, rewind it, and we're going to go back and talk about how you could have earned your points. All right, I'm going to roll it. Go. 2, 3, 4, 5. Hopefully you made your decision. Puck gets turned over. Bedard, Bubble Bedard, off to the races. Gets a shot on net. Puck's now in the offensive zone, right? And this was a decision made at the far blue line. Ends up trickling in. All right, let's run this back a little bit. Claude Giroux, obviously been doing it for years. Gets the puck right here. Turnovers at your offensive blue line. So in this case, Giroux has the puck at his offensive blue line. He tries to force a puck through two defenders, technically three defenders. Ends up getting turned over and heading down the rink. His options here, and this is how you get your point. If you said drive wide and try to get to the net that way. If you said drive wide, escape and try to find a soft area up here. Or if you said just dump the puck in, go forecheck and live to fight another day. That's how you earn your points. Trying to feather this through right here, team. Trying to feather this through three guys, turning the puck over. Now the Blackhawks don't have to back check because you just turned the puck over at the far blue line is a bad idea. Now, Claude Giroux is obviously one of the best in the game, one of the best to do it. It's a lot easier to make these decisions from the computer screen than it is when you're actually on the ice. I understand that. But in this situation, just throwing the puck down or trying to beat the guys wide or trying to beat the guys wide, escape, find some more space and try to get the puck to the net. That's how you would earn your points. Hey, it is what it is. It's a turnover on Bedard's stick, who's one of the most dangerous players in the game. He ends up flying down the ice, getting a good shot, and then going back towards the play, getting it right back, kind of a squeaker on the goalie, but is what it is. Let's go on to clip number 5. Here we go, clip number 5. Now, this is a bonus clip because there's going to be two decisions made by Connor Bedard that you are going to decide on the fly as well. So make sure you're keeping track. By now, you should have 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4 points. And this one's worth 2, so it's going to be out of 6 points. Again, don't forget to comment below how many points you got in this video. Let's roll it. I'm going to go through both. So I'm going to pause it. You get 5 seconds, make your decision. Play it to the next spot. Pause it. You get 5 seconds to make your decision. Play it through the goal. Run it back. See what your score was. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make your decision. Next play. Go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Finishes with the Michigan. Now, hey, if you said Michigan, great, but let's run it back and start from the beginning. And we'll talk about, yes, it was in Michigan, but that you're gonna have another way to get a point as well. So zone entry. Again, we kind of just saw this by Giroux in the last clip where he had some pretty good defense on him, just like here, where Bedard's got four guys kind of watching him here. Nothing through the middle, because we don't want turnovers at our blue line, at the far blue line. We want to start getting that puck in. If you said skate it in, again, we got a little bit of a gap here. If you said skate it in and get a little shot, or if you said dump it in, or if you said drive wide, those will all give you a point, okay? He does a great job here of just driving to the net, getting a quick shot here. This is a perfect, right? It's a little bit higher in the slot. Still, getting the puck on net is never a bad thing. He decides to get the puck on net. So again, if you said get the puck on net, if you said drive the puck wide or dump it in, those will all get you a point. If you said pass across the middle, go back and watch the Giroux clip we just had in the last one, and just understand that turnovers at the far blue line are not a good thing. Then the puck ends up coming up the wall. Now watch this little shoulder check he does as it's coming down the wall right here. We can see that he is looking up the ice at what plays can be made. And as he's seeing this, he's already made his decision that, hey, there is nothing in the middle of the ice right here. Absolutely nothing. So the play is going to be to the far side of the net. He knows that. So if you said bring it to the far side of the net to create more space, if you said Michigan, even better. Obviously, we're not always going to be, we shouldn't always be trying Michigan's, but hey, it is today's game. Now he's got his back turned towards him. He knows he needs to get the puck to the other side. Again, he ends up doing the Michigan. So if you said in any way, get the puck to this side of the ice to find somebody in the front or to just to create some more space, but getting it from the strong side because of, let's go back, just because of all these players here. All these players are on this side of the ice pretty much, besides this guy's kind of in the middle, but you want to get to the other side of the ice because there's a lot more space over here. That's how you earned your points. Okay? Let's watch that Michigan one more time. Boom, what a goal. Now, hopefully you kept track of your points. What I want you to do now is go in the comments and put your score. It's out of 6. So your score can be anywhere from 0 to 6. It doesn't matter if you got 0 or if you got 6. What matters is if you've learned. And now the biggest thing is the consistency moving forward. So make sure you're taking the time to watch these videos. We have shorter ones on our Instagram and our other social media channels. So make sure you check those things out. If you have any questions, always reach out, danny@projecthockey.com. If you want to join our live weekly Zoom sessions, become a member, projecthockey.com. Cheapest hockey development you'll ever get as far as money, but as far as value, it's one of the best out there. I guarantee you're going to learn something when you sign up. So hit the links. Let us know if you have any questions. In the meantime, get out there, do the work.
All right, hockey family, great job developing that hockey IQ. Now, don't forget to post your score below. Did you get 0? Did you get 5? Did you get somewhere in between? Honestly, it doesn't matter. What matters is the consistency. Putting in that work every single day, even if it's a couple minutes a day, one video, two videos, a full game watch, whatever it is, put that consistent work in and keep getting better. Now, be honest with yourself, put your score in, because when we do another one of these, hopefully your score starts to go up and up and up. It's all about making those split second decisions. It's all about getting better at the game. It's all about developing that hockey IQ so you can take it, get on the ice, and go be a better hockey player. If you have any questions, please reach out. In the meantime, keep a lookout for the next video. All right, do the work.